Good morning. Our opening song will be found in the hymnal number 239, number 239. Please join in singing Good Christian Friends. Please stand.
Mercy and his forgiveness. who were pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so, in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Forever, the Lord remembers His
And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself a sword pierced, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." There was a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then as a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew, became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
So when I had to go back, it was far more traumatic than leaving.
me the first time because I had to leave in the middle of Christmas. And so I had gone to dinner with friends all the way out of town, and I rushed back to the house to say goodbye to mom and dad one last time, and we had a big cry fest. But anyway, the point of all of this, and telling you this, is I couldn't go home again. Everything had changed. The future was set. And as a young man, I had begun to set out on my own. And, you know, in my youthfulness, and, you know, I had some sense that this is probably what God was wanting me to do. But, you know, had I not gotten up there, you know, the direction of my life would have been very different. And it was there that I continued to be involved as I worked at NASA, that I was really involved in teaching CCD and working with RCIA and being a lector, Eucharistic minister, whatever else they wanted me to do in church. And then before I know it, I was encountering other young people myself, like myself, who were real involved in church, and a couple of guys that were going into seminary, and they started asking me the question, what are you going to do? So they sort of already begun to think about quitting their jobs and going to graduate school, seminary, so before you know it, you're right. But the point is, you can't go back again. When you make that definitive break, the past is the past and the future is the future. And just like Abraham, when he got called by God to leave his home, to go with his wife Sarah and his family from his hometown of Ur of the Chaldees, which is very close to where modern Baghdad is today, I think. And he first went north up to Haran, and there he separated with Lot, his nephew, and they kind of went down separately in Canaan. And following that fertile crescent, remember in world history, it's easier to do come north and then around, because it was a desert in the middle. And then Abraham settled in the land of Canaan. And God spoke to him, and he didn't know who God was. God called out to him in the night and said, get up, move, leave. I have big plans for you. And you know, this God was not well known. I mean, he was not in the pantheon, you know, didn't show up in the Chaldean Gazette or whatever, know about God, that's God called Abraham. But he listened, and the readings of the day just talk about this in such a beautiful way, but the second reading says, he felt that the one who was making a promise to him was trustworthy. He trusted God, he put his faith in God, and it was counted to him as righteousness, the first reading says. He gets into the land of Canaan. He doesn't have children. And the Lord tells him, look up, Abraham. Look up at the night sky. You know, 4,000 years ago, there was no light pollution. It was beautiful. Every night was gorgeous. It was not cloudy. There are not many cloudy nights in the Middle East. And he could see the magnificence of the stars. And the Lord said to him, count them. See, it's impossible. Even so, the Lord descend into me, Abraham, and go to the seashore, try to count the sand grains. Your descendants will be more numerous than the sands of the seashore. And Abraham must have been thinking, well, how am I going to do that? I don't have kids. My wife can't conceive. This is kind of already after the whole Hagar thing with Ishmael. That got left out of this reading. And the Lord responded to Abraham. And in another part that's left out, you know, he shows up for dinner in the form of three men, right? And has dinner with Abraham and promises indeed that he will have a son. And Sarah goes, oh yeah, right, she laughs. So when they have the baby, they name the baby Laughter, Yitzhak, or Isaac, the Hebrew, okay? And then God tells Abraham, well, take your child and sacrifice it. Sounds completely insane. But Abraham obeys God. And therefore God gives Isaac back, spares Isaac, of course, and gives him back to Abraham. Abraham puts his faith in God, even to that degree. And God blesses Abraham. And he says, I will fulfill my promise to you, Abraham, and I will bless you. And that is the beginning of the story of the people of Israel, through whom all the nations of the world would be blessed. And we know the story of the Old Testament, how the descendants of Isaac, Jacob, and his 12 sons, and Joseph, that whole story, how they get to Egypt, and then centuries later, God frees the people of Israel and leads them back to the promised land under the leadership of Moses, and builds a nation of them, so that through this nation, all nations would be blessed. And then finally, King David comes along, the man after God's own heart, and makes his promise to David. But in so doing, the promise to Abraham is being fulfilled as well. And ultimately, the plan of God to build that those numerous descendants comes down to the life of Jesus himself. And it's just so beautiful that the readings have the story of Mary and Joseph bringing the death of Jesus to the temple on the 40th day after his birth, to have him consecrated to the Lord in the temple as the law required. And whom do they encounter? But Simeon and Anna. And Luke is so beautiful in his ability to craft the story. It's almost as if Abraham and Sarah are standing there, the persons of Simeon and Anna. And Simeon takes the child and says, here, this is the child who fulfills the promise. This is the one who was sent, the glory of Israel, the light to all the nations. Everyone is blessed through him. And the prophetess, who has not reported exactly what she says more or less the same thing. It's as if Abraham and Sarah are standing there saying, but the promise has been fulfilled. God is faithful to his promise. And he has built this great people and this great family unto himself. And that's where we come in, brothers and sisters, because we are united to Christ. We are the followers of Jesus Christ. We have been united to him and baptized in his name and commissioned to live his life in the world today. And St. Paul says further that because of our faith, we imitate Abraham, and we are children of Abraham because of the faith that we have in the Son of God. Abraham is our father, and we are his children as well as our Jewish brothers and sisters, I dare say, as well as our Islamic brothers and sisters who look to Abraham as their father. We ourselves are joined to God and his promise. And the fulfillment of the promise that God made to Abraham long ago, numerous as the stars in the sky, the sands of the seashore, are all of us one vast human family. And as we celebrate today the Holy Family, we look at the humble lives of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, living in Nazareth, growing up as a family. It reminds us that we are joined to that family and joined to all other people in the great family of faith. We are called to be brother and sister to everyone, everyone without exception. We think today of children around the world who are being deprived of family life because of war and persecution and hatred, children in Gaza and Israel, children in Ukraine. Everywhere there seems to be violence. But that, brothers and sisters, is where we need to be in our prayer, in our advocacy, in our being with others. Everyone is brother and sister to me. That is our call as followers of Jesus. We must reach out in love and kindness to everyone. Even people down the street that irritate us, even people in our own community. thankful to God for the Son Jesus, thankful for the gift of salvation that He brings, we rejoice in being part of that great family of God. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Please join in the singing of our offertory song, Angels We Have Heard on High, in your hymnal at number 236, number 236.
Thank you.
offerings may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, we may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace. Christ, Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through him, the holy exchange that restores our life has shone forth today in splendor. When our frailty is assumed by your word, not only is human mortality receive an ending honor, but by this wondrous union, we too are made eternal. And so, in company with the chorus of angels, we praise you. Joy we proclaim.
Thank you.
charity and in his holy living sacrifice, look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by his death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit of Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, our Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your Lord. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Draw departed brothers and sisters to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. In Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Thank you.
Supper of the Lamb. Lord, I have prayer that you should enter under my roof, but I only say the word for my soul.
Thank you.
Bring those who refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever through Christ our Lord. As you have been sitting in the home bath, take with you not only the sacrament we have celebrated, but also the word of God which we have heard, as well as the affection of this parish community. Ask for the prayers of those whom you visited, return home now with God's peace and blessing. Let's now recite the prayer for the new bath and the moral and loving faith in God. Through the years that people of our diocese have appreciated the prayers of love and Lady of Help Suffering, in times of war, disaster, epidemic, and illness, we come to you, Father, Mary, Mother, and ask you to help us in battle today against violence, murder, and racism. We implore you to give us assurance, knowing that we build a community founded on the values of Jesus, which gives respect to the life and dignity of all people, bless parents, that they may form their children in faith, bless and protect our youth, that they may be peacemakers of our time, give consolation to those who have lost loved ones through violence. Hear our prayer and give us perseverance to be a voice for life and human dignity in our community. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Our Lady of Hope Supper. Brother Ariadne Lee. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth in peace and mass. Take it. Merry Christmas.
Join in the singing of our closing song, number 242, Go Tell It on the Mountain, number 242.
Go tell it on the mountain. they got us.